morning, guys. Welcome back to the YouTube. Haven't done this in a long time. Been filming a lot of Instagram content. Still been here, there, everywhere, busy as. But today we're doing a YouTube. Gonna run you through an off-season session. Technically, I've been off-season. Have been for about 5 weeks now. Planned 16 to 18 week push. So about 12, 13 weeks left of this push. We're just here at MuscleWorks today. Gonna run through a push session, chest, shoulders, arms, chat a little bit in between, but not too much. Just wanna crack on with training, really. This is my push B, and you'll see it as we go through what exercise I'm doing. And yeah, let's crack on. If you notice, I've set the pins quite far back. That stretch, I've actually increased my range of motion on the flies that I've started doing. So I've lightened the weight. Here we've got the stack, but I'm assuming it's a light machine, or I'm just feeling really strong today. But I used to probably come here. Here is still within my active range because I don't get no pressure on the shoulders, but it's just an inch or two deeper. And I'm getting a better stretch, a lot more blood flow in the pec. Triceps need warming up a little bit. So after my flies, obviously the chest is nice and warm. Where if we do delts and we've done cuff side raises prior, the delts are nice and primed. However, when I go into my heavy pressing now, I'm just doing a little bit of tricep warm up. Skull crushers, dumbbells, pull downs, 15 to 20, two sets. Just get the tricep joint, the elbow and the tricep warm so that they're working when I do the lockout on the presses. So I'm gonna do that now. PB, let's go. Ooh. This rotation of push, I have the pec flies as you saw. We then go into the incline Cybex Smith because they have this at Factory where I'm training now. I switch gyms between Crayford's and Factory. I have a push, pull, arms, legs at Crayford's, and then I have a second push, pull, arms, legs at Factory. And we just rotate week to week or day to day. And they have the Cybex Smith there, so I've got this. Then we move into the incline hammer strength and then some dips today as well. Overall, how I'm feeling with my training, I feel good. I'm on about 4,300 calories. Weight's slowly going up, but I'm keeping 30 minutes cardio in there, keeping 10K steps in there. As you all know, I was injured last off season. Inflamed ligament absolutely messed with me mentally, physically. I have kept on top of that. I have a prehab routine in the morning, ab routine, my cardio's there, my steps are there, and my training is flying, and we've still got 12 weeks left of this push. We'll talk a little bit more about the shows. That's next year. And I've always said to the camera, I'm in no rush. I've got other things on the horizon. My business is growing. I've got other people that are close to me competing this year only because they are close friends. I'm not actually taking on clients who want to compete yet until after mine. But yeah, we've got a job to do this year. You know, 2023 and 24, it's the biggest years for the business, biggest years for myself. So I'm just focusing on enjoying my training at the moment, which I am. Everything's going up. I'm hitting PBs every session. And then, yeah, the enjoyment is key in the long term, so. Right, let's go. So rest pulls on here as well. I've been running rest pulls for about 2 weeks. I felt absolutely trash yesterday on my rest day. Did some computer work. I obviously do my cardio and my steps in the morning. And then I just sat there all day on my laptop or on the sofa in a lying position whilst doing work. I was smoked because I did legs the day before that. So I do push, pull with the deadlifts, arms and then legs. and I was absolutely smoked yesterday. So probably from the higher volume from 2 weeks ago. But today I still feel great, so I'm tracking the rest balls. Not two, just one. Because as food goes up, you've got to understand your recovery is going to get slightly better. If your androgens go up a tiny bit, recovery is going to be slightly better. So just about balancing, pushing, fatigue, build up, recover. My sleep's great at the moment, like best it's been, and that's key in recovering. So make sure you're getting your sleep. Come on. Oh. Yep, let's go. That's all good. And your feet, they're waving at you. And they do that and they're not even looking at you. Right, we're gonna run into some weighted dips now. So I've had these in for about 5 weeks. We're not necessarily looking to bias either chest or triceps, just doing a normal weighted dip, coming down as deep as I feel comfortable, getting a stretch on the pec, but also locking out the triceps at the top. Obviously this is the fourth movement in the session, so you're gonna be relatively fatigued by this point, but I'm definitely trying to run these up. Three plates. I think I did two plates the other day, so I'll do a bodyweight warm-up and then I'll go straight into my working set. Weighted dip, great movement for the chest, great movement for triceps, a little bit of front delt there as well. We've done two variants of incline previously to hit those upper pecs. Now this is gonna hit a bit of upper pec, also mid pec as well, so we cover all angles. Rest pulls. Ooh. I must say that the arm days have helped massively with bringing up buys and tries. I don't necessarily program in arms early on for a client who's just joined me unless their arms are lagging massively. First couple of years, we'll put it this way, for the first 5 years of training, I didn't really have an arm day. The odd one here and there, but in my program split, I was doing heavy pushes, heavy pulls, which will still stimulate the arm growth, you know, tagging them at the end of the sessions. But now I'm at a point where, like, right, we're looking at specifics. Bring up the top line, get wider side delts, get bigger triceps, because my triceps lag a little bit. That's when you start incorporating an arm day. If you're a novice and you've been training 6 months to a year, do you need an arm day? No. Probably need to be getting your squat, your deadlift, your bench, your pull-ups, your weighted dips very, very strong to build a lot of meat on the physique. Then you can start adding in an arm day on top of that. So arms are a very small muscle, right? At the end of the day, you never see someone with massive arms and nothing else. So, but don't make that mistake when you first start training. First year or two, just get big everywhere and then start focusing on specifics after that. Right, guys, as you can see, this is a first off-season video that we've basically done. Wrapped up a big push session. As I've said in the video, I'm happy with how things are going. In terms of the competing timeline, I think we're going to do next year. It just gives me a chance to have two or three off-seasons before we start prep. But again, things change. So, as I said, I'm just enjoying myself. I'm going with the flow. I'm getting more size. I'm getting bigger. I'm enjoying my training. I'm eating. I'm sleeping well. I will be documenting the off-season with some YouTube videos, but you have to understand that, you know, the YouTube is taking a little bit of a backseat. I'm trying to build my Instagram, build my clientele, and then the YouTube will still run alongside that, just a little bit less frequently. That doesn't mean we're going to stop. I will document this off-season number one. I've got another off-season two, potentially three, before the competition. But when we do start prep, trust me, we'll be in the best position that I've ever had in terms of physically, mentally, but also in terms of where the business is. So there'll be a lot more viewers and eyes on the series, on the They Will Know series, because one day they will fucking know, trust me. Thank you for all the support. I hope you enjoyed the YouTube video. Safe.